So my first tip is start saving your stuff to OneDrive. This is all about changing your personal habits. You've most probably got used to saving files to your local machine over the last couple of years, and that in itself can be risky because it leaves you open to stuff like viruses, ransomware, and hardware failure. The beauty of OneDrive is that because it's stored in the cloud, if your laptop or your PC goes down, you can log into any other PC and basically just pick up where you left off and re-download all of your files. And the nice thing about OneDrive is that that functionality is really easy to do. So let's say, for instance, I want to create a Word document and I want to save it to OneDrive. So here's my Word document. I'm just going to go in and open it up. And as you can see, I've got some text on screen. So to save this to OneDrive is simple. All I do is click on File, Save, and then select OneDrive. Here I'll then have a list of all of the folders that I've set up on OneDrive. So in this case, I'm going to go and save it to Demo, and I'm just going to call it Test. I click Save, and that file is now being uploaded directly to the cloud. So I've not got to go and drag and drop it to any other part of my hard drive or do anything special with it. And there's a couple of benefits that you get from working from OneDrive. The first one is you now have Autosave enabled. So what will happen is you no longer have to click on the Save key every time Word detects a significant change, such as you've entered some text or something on those lines. It will auto-save the document. What it also gives me the ability to do is click on the Share button, type in someone's email address, and then just share that link with them directly. So again, it's just speeding up that process of being able to share a document. The good thing is, especially with OneDrive, is that process of saving a document to OneDrive is the same regardless of what Microsoft application you're looking at. So if I go into Excel, for instance, I'm just going to go out and open up a new workbook. If you want to save this to OneDrive, again, it's exactly the same process. So it's File, Save, click on OneDrive, select the folder where you want to save it. So again, I'll go to Iain Demo. I'm just going to call this Test 2. And as soon as that file's saved up in OneDrive, again, I get that auto-save function. So especially when you're utilizing Excel, it's really, really useful. It can save you from some key mistakes. So that was the first way of saving your files to OneDrive. The next way is you can actually use the web browser. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to open up my web browser, straight into Google, and I'm going to go and go to the OneDrive web portal, which is onedrive.live.com. And as you can see, I've been there once or twice. I'm going to open it up. Once you're here, all you then need to do is click on Sign In, type in your email address and password, and then click in Next. But just for the sake of time, I've already done that. So there's my password. I'm just going to click on Sign In, and it takes me directly to the OneDrive interface. And what this does is this basically gives me access to all of the files, all of the folders, everything that I've uploaded directly into OneDrive. And as you can see, this is a completely new, fresh install, so there's nothing here. Multiple ways I can upload files. I can click on Upload, go to Folder, and then I can then browse my desktop and select the folder that I want to upload. In this case, I want to upload that OneDrive demo. If I then click on Upload, it will say if I want to upload the content, just click on Upload, give it a couple of seconds, and you'll get a little progress bar just up here. And all of the content from my desktop is now uploaded into OneDrive, which means I can now access this content from any mobile device where the app's installed, any PC with an internet connection, and a web browser, making it super safe. You can also use drag and drop. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go and delete the folder I've just uploaded. So there's the folder. I'm just going to select it, right click, and delete. And I'm just going to go and take up half the screen. So there is the folder that I want to upload. And you can just also drag and drop directly into OneDrive. And as you can see, it will upload directly into the system, exactly the same way as it did before. If I expand it, I can then go into my folder. So that's my first top tip for utilizing OneDrive, is again, actually start using it, start getting into the habit of saving stuff to the cloud, especially if it's important content such as photos, files that you want to keep, or anything you want to be able to access anywhere at any time. So my next top tip is all around using the search function that's built into OneDrive, and specifically the web search. So here I am looking at my OneDrive folder structure, which I've just uploaded, and search is found in the top left-hand corner. In this case, I want to find all files and folders with the word OneDrive in them. Once I've entered it in, just hit enter. And what will now happen is OneDrive will show me all files which contain the word OneDrive. So obviously I've got OneDrive demo folder, OneDrive Word document, and again, those files contain the word OneDrive in the file name. This one here, for instance, doesn't. So what OneDrive is utilizing is it's using a very clever optical character recognition technology, and is able to search for the words within images and PDFs, making it a really powerful tool. So here, if I go into this JPEG, this is an image, and as you can see, in the middle of it, it's got the word OneDrive. So it's a really useful bit of functionality and can help make you locate content really, really quickly. So my next top tip is all around sharing from OneDrive. And again, this is designed so it's really quick and really, really easy to do. In this case, there's multiple ways of sharing a file. Pretty much all of them are exactly the same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share this file with an individual. All I need to do, select the file, then get the share button appear in the menu. I just click on share, and I've then got a couple of options. So depending again on if you've got a personal or a business version of OneDrive, will depend on what the options are. So in this case, I've got a business version of OneDrive. Here I can click on the drop-down menu, and I've then got multiple options. So if I click on anyone, what it will do is it will create a hyperlink that anyone who has access to it will be able to basically look and view these files. I've then got people in Morris IT Solutions, so that's anyone in my immediate organization. People with existing access, so that's if I've already basically made some changes and I want to share it out with an existing people. Or in this particular example, I want to share it with someone external from my organization. I can also enable editing, which is controlled down here. And in this case, yes, I want this person to edit. So I'm going to select specific people and then click on apply. I'm now going to type in the email address. And then all I'm going to do is click on send. So what will happen now is OneDrive will generate an email which will be sent out to that particular user. And in that case, I've got a separate instance of OneDrive set up, so I can show you what that looks like from their side. So I'm just going to minimize this browser and open up Chrome. And here's my Outlook.com OneDrive account. So all I'll do is go into my email. And as you can see, I've got an email informing me that someone shared a file with me. I can open that up, and I'm then just going to click on open. So when I click on that link, it will open up a web page asking me to verify my identity. So all I need to do is punch in my email address, click on next, and it will now ask me for a code. So if I go back to my inbox, there's my code. I copy, grab that, copy and paste it into my link. And as you can see, I now get full edit access of that PowerPoint. So I can come in, make changes to it, insert objects, and collaborate with that individual on that particular document. This also works with folders as well. So again, that was an example of me sharing a single file. But if I wanted to share a folder. I'll just jump back to my other browser. So let's go back into my file. This time I want to share this particular folder. All I need to do, again, select the folder, click on share. I'm going to change it to specific people. Then click on apply, type in my username again. And it's remembered me because Outlook's quite clever. Then I'm just going to click on send. And if I now jump back to my other Outlook, so in a second, I'll get an email, which is just popped in there. So there, as you can see, Iain's sent a folder for me. If I just click on open, because I've just verified who I am, I won't have to do it in this particular instance. But as you can see, I've now got full access to that folder. So my next top tip is the installation and use of the OneDrive desktop app. This really does make using OneDrive almost too simple. It's fully integrated into your File Explorer. So if I open up my File Explorer, and I'll just maximize that. And then just on the left-hand side, as you can see, I've got something, a little icon that says OneDrive Personal. I can click in there, and I now have a folder called OneDrive Personal, where it's got this little green tick by the side of the file or folder. That means that that file has been sunk with OneDrive. So just to show you what that looks like, I'm just going to go and split this into two. So here's my OneDrive web view. If I go into that, as you can see, I've got a folder called PDF. If I go into there, I've got a folder called PDF. If I open up that, I've got a file called PDF. If I go into here, I've also got the same file called PDF. So if I right click on the file, or into the folder, go to, let's say, for instance, I want to create a plain text document. I'm going to give it a quick name. I'm just going to call this Hello. And I'm just going to put a smiley face in there. And almost instantaneously, as soon as I've started to type into there, that document has traveled from the web browser right the way to the OneDrive servers and has replicated on my machine. So I can now access that file both on my local machine and via the web browser. So if I want to work offline, I can simply just disconnect the internet. I don't have to have a network connection and I'll still be able to access that document. So I'm just going to go and minimize this window and let's go back out to my top file. So let's go and create a completely new folder within OneDrive. So again, I'm in the app. I'm just going to right click, new folder. I'm going to call this images and hit enter. And as you can see, there's a little icon which indicates that that file or folder is syncing with OneDrive. I'm just going to open that up. And as you can see, there's no files in here at the moment. So this scenario, what I want to do is I want to get some files from my local PC into OneDrive really quickly. Now, if it's just one file, all I need to do is locate where that file lives on my desktop or anywhere on my local machine. But in this case, I've got a folder just here and here's all my files. So I'm just going to grab a file and just drag it in. And again, it's just syncing. Give it a second and that should now be visible through the web app. So if I go back into the web app, let's go back into OneDrive. Let's close that document down. Let's leave that. And let's go up to my top level file. So as you can see, I've now got a folder called images. If I go into that image, there is the image that I've just uploaded directly via my desktop app. So as you can see, it's really, really quick. If I want to stick the entire folder in, well, that's just as simple as grabbing the folder and dropping it into OneDrive. Again, depending on the size of the folder, it can take a little bit of time to sync with the desktop. But as you saw, in this case, it was pretty quick. So if I now go back into OneDrive, and if I go back into my files up to the highest level, if I go into images, there is the folder called OneDrive Images. If I click in there, there are all of the images that were on that folder. So it means that I can access all of that content, both directly from my computer and also from the web. So the desktop app makes it really, really easy. And that, again, depending on your local setup from your IT team, you may need someone to get something installed on your PC. If you're using a remote machine, such as hosted via Azure or something on those lines, there may be some restrictions around installing the application. But again, always ask your local IT support team. And they are my top tips for utilizing OneDrive. Thank you very much. I hope you found them useful.